Hey guys, Fairlight here, and I'm just throwing up a quick video to show you guys how to kill Jason. There's been a lot of rumors going around about how to do it, and some theories and misinformation getting thrown around, but I'm going to show you how to do it consistently. This is a team effort. You can't kill Jason alone. So you're going to need a minimum of two players to pull it off, but three or four would be a lot safer. Now, there's a few different things you need to get done before you can kill Jason, and these steps can mostly be done in any order you want. First of all, you're going to need to grab Pamela's old sweater. Pamela, who is Jason's mom, can be found in a couple of different spots on each map hidden in a little cabin. The cabin does move around and it's kind of random each time, but once you learn all the different spots where it can appear, it shouldn't be too hard to find it. You're going to have to explore a little bit. But once you do find it, head inside, grab the sweater. Now keep in mind, for this part, you must be playing as a female. It doesn't matter which girl you're playing as long as it's a girl. Later on, we're going to trick Jason by pretending to be his mom. So if you're playing as a guy, the voice won't sound right. He doesn't fall for it. So you have to be a female character, whoever's doing this part. Look for this old cabin. Head inside. Pamela's body is on the floor. The sweater is on the table nearby. Now, keep in mind, when you go into this cabin, Jason gets a warning right away and he'll know you're in there. And he can teleport right across the map and he'll be on top of you right away. So be ready. This is a step you may want to just leave for last. Next thing you need to get done is knocking the mask off of Jason. Now, my friends and I have tested this with just about every weapon in the game. We've hit him multiple times from different angles, hit him in the body, hit him in the head, and based on everything I've seen, your best bet is definitely the machete. The machete knocks his mask loose, usually in only one or two hits. It's your best bet by far. Plus, you're gonna need a machete later on for the final blow, so having one already just makes your life that much easier. Some folks have been saying you need to keep his mask afterwards, but I've been able to kill him without the mask, so I don't think you need to worry about picking it up. Just knock it off him and you should be good. Remember to aim up when you swing, so that you can go for that headshot. I think that helps. The last piece of the puzzle is Tommy Jarvis. Tommy is a special character who only shows up to replace a player who's already escaped or a player who's already been killed. Now, I don't actually have a video of the radio part, but on each map, there's going to be a radio randomly placed in one of the cabins. You need to find the radio and place a distress call, which Tommy will later on answer when a player needs to be replaced. Tommy is faster, stronger, and sneakier than most of the other characters. He's by far the best character in the game, and he's the only one that can actually kill Jason. Now, he's going to need a machete to seal the deal. So even though he does start off with a shotgun, you're gonna have to ditch the shotgun in favor of a machete. So maybe hand the shotgun to a teammate and get Tommy that machete. Okay, now that we have a girl wearing the old sweater, Jason's mask knocked off his face, and Tommy Jarvis armed with a machete, we're ready to end this. Give the sweater girl a baseball bat or an axe. When Jason gets close to her, she can activate the sweater like an item and start imitating his mom. Once she tells him to calm down and come closer, Jason will drop his guard, he'll walk up to her, and she just needs to whack him over the head with the bat. Once he drops to his knees, Tommy comes swooping in for the kill, nails him in the head with some machete-flavored justice. That's our boy right there, look at that. Delicious, slow-mo, cinematic kills! Now, I don't think it actually matters who does the stun. I think once the girl gets him to drop his guard, a different player with a bat or an axe could stun him. As long as Jason is close enough to get in there and get that final kill, you're good to go. Now, he's only going to drop his guard for a few seconds, and then once he's stunned, he's only going to be stunned for a few seconds. So each of these things needs to happen in pretty rapid succession, otherwise you're going to miss out. Now at this point, once Jason's dead, all the players left alive in the lobby win by default. Now obviously, in this video, a lot of it was staged because we had our friend playing as Jason standing still while we did all this testing. In a real match, you're not going to have a Jason who's making it so easy for you, so you're going to have to play it really smart. My suggestion, and I haven't actually done it yet, hopefully I'll be able to get a video of that, but my suggestion is, you know, one or two guys with really high strength scores to keep hitting Jason and keep him distracted, and a girl with a high stealth score to hopefully sneak in there and get that sweater, and maybe leave the sweater for last, because you know Jason will teleport there to try and protect it. That's all I got for you. If you have any better advice, throw it in the comments below, and if enough of you like and or subscribe, maybe someday I'll make another video. Good luck, and good hunting.
Sweater cam!
Oh, you should wear it.
It's like I can't believe it.